Hello, Chicago. I'm Jerry Springer, and I'm on the radio. No, wait. Wait, where are you going? What? The people. Stop it. You're not. There's no reason to leave. I'm only going to be here 4 days. It's not. I'm not doing commentary. Stay. Don't go. Oh, jeez. In today's economy, why would you guys want to be walking out? I don't know how to work this board. What am I going to. Oh.
Did you say 4 days? I was told 40 minutes.
Andrea,
I was told be here for 40 minutes. Help Jerry out.
How did you?
Steve might be a little cynical. Help Jerry out. I didn't think 4 days.
They told me I could be here till Friday. No,
it's just. Oh God! Do you know what time I get up in the morning?
Jerry, it's
no. Why would I know what time God. You got up in the morning?
It's a leap. Gotta say my name.
It's a leap week, Jerry.
Yeah. It's a leap week.
Right.
Right.
So your 4 days, really, to us, it's a shorter period of time.
No, to you, it's going to be forever.
Steve, I was going to say to us, it's 4 years.
Oh.
Maybe God. 40.
Why is
in
it
my
every
world.
Place I go, everyone wants to quit? In today's economy, wouldn't we? First of all, how did they pick you to get it?
Well, you know, they said basically I was forced and they bribed me with a lot of money. No, actually, they said, you know what? Help Jerry. Be the Kelly to his Wacky Regis. Be the Dalmatian to his Cruella de Vil. I drew the short straw.
You poor thing.
They asked everybody. They all said no. The receptionist said no. The assistant said no. The engineer said no.
It's just, what is it? Is it the way? Now, wait, this is radio, right?
I was bribed in many ways. No, I was not.
I'm very happy to have you
here. I thought I'd just help you along, anything you might need.
Will you hold my
hand? As long as you don't get, as long as you don't get controversial, because I know that's not in your blood.
No. But what, this is radio. Where do I look when I talk?
Well, whatever you do. Well, thank God it's raining outside because a lot of times, especially for you, don't be looking outside because we get a lot of young women sometimes who come to the showcase
studio
window.
We'll be here till 4.
I don't think you're helping your cause at all.
No. But here's the thing. First of all, why are we in front of a window doing this? This is radio.
This is the fishbowl. This is the showcase studio.
Oh, this
the
is
opulent studios of WGN Radio.
Yeah, then why do I have to clean it up? Here's what we're going to do today. We're going to have a good time here today.
We are.
And we're going to talk about some fun things, and we're also going to talk about some serious things that are going on in the world. We're going to talk about, truthfully, the reason I took this job, you know, for 4 days. It's not like I'm getting paid, but the reason, or am I? Kevin, am I getting paid for that? We'll talk about that later. But the reason I'm doing this for 4 days is because I figured this is my entree into politics. See, Rush became leader of the Republican Party through a radio show, so I'm figuring if I do really good 4 days, I'll be the leader of the Democratic Party.
Oh, is that the way you're going? Is that what you're thinking?
Well, after these 4 days, it's a no-brainer.
I know a good former governor who could hook you up.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. This is there Illinois.
Be nice.
I forgot that.
Be nice.
How come I never got a
are
call?
You,
I didn't know it was for sale. I got money. I could have been a senator. I could have been a contender. Nobody calls me. I have to read about it in the paper that it was for sale, for God's sakes.
You
this
didn't
is
get
an
a
outrage.
Call, apparently.
No, jeezle. So anyway, last night, this is obviously the big story that's going on. Last night, dancing with the stars.
I am so excited. Mary Vandeveld, your traffic reporter,
yes,
is a huge dancing fan.
I wasn't going to watch it this time.
Oh, did you saw when
Cochran
Jerry was on?
Cochran told me I had to, so I, 2 hours.
All right, well, who was your partner, Jerry?
My partner was Kim Johnson.
Kim.
And here's the Kim Stallion. Johnson is the beautiful young lady. She's the blonde hair,
yes.
Tall.
Right.
Okay, from Australia. Now, here's the great way. Okay, so I was in the third season. Well, I forget. I think it was the third season. Kim wins Dancing with the Stars in Australia. And the prize there when she wins is, one, she wins and whatever the money it was, and then she gets to fly. They fly her to America to be on Dancing with the Stars in America. So she dances. She wins. The confetti comes down, cheering, wonderful. You're on your way to America. And the cameras follow her. She goes to the airport, and they fly her to America. She lands in L.A., and then they drive her to the studio because she's going to meet the person that she's going to get to dance with in America. This is the high point in her life.
She is the season,
so excited.
Is this the season when she was with Warren Sapp?
No.
Oh.
This was her first trip over here.
Right.
She gets off the plane, comes to the studio. They walk her in, and here's your partner with the cameras rolling. Jerry Springer.
Is that what she said?
Yeah.
Just like that?
It was such a downer.
Now, how did they decide? I've always wanted to know. How did they decide who's going to be partnered
with
who?
Yeah, how did you know?
Well, well, they don't tell you. I mean,
no, but how
I,
did they make the decision?
Well, I thought, well, maybe they...
Straws? Height? Kim drew the short one?
Yeah, well, I was, strangely, I was one of the taller ones in the competition in the year, that the season that I was in. And also, I probably needed the most help, and she, you know, she had taken care of an older father or something like that to me. Oh, my
grandfather.
You know. Well, they should. Here's the only thing that I really don't like about the show. They should have a seniors division, like a seniors tour, like they do in golf.
Because
I was 30, I was 35 years older than everyone else in the competition, and that just wasn't fair.
Right. Right. Just like Steve Wozniak, right? Isn't he the Apple guy who's on now?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
I
mean, they really should.
Contestant.
But I got advice for him because I did the same dance every week. I just did it at different speeds.
Uh-huh.
But here's the trick. Every week, Kim and I worked it out that my dance would end in that same far corner. And that's because that's where the paramedic was sitting.
Is there really a paramedic sitting off
in
the corner?
Oh, I swear to God, that is true.
Is there oxygen?
Every week, I'm going.
Well, yeah, remember Marie passed out?
That's right. They need
what was
oxygen.
The drama in your season besides you? I mean, Marie passed out in the one.
Oh,
Jewel got hurt.
Sarah Evans.
Oh, she hence the cutout.
She dropped out in the middle, you know, just dealing with her husband or whatever.
Personal problem.
Yeah. But she, by the way, she was, and she's such a nice person, other than really very talented. And she invited me to join her on tour here in Maryville.
Oh, was this the Dancing with the Stars tour?
No, she was singing at one of her concerts. And she brought me out on stage and we sang a couple of songs and that was the end of her career.
Great. It's looking up for you and me, Mary. How about that?
Oh, yeah. This is great. You be sure. Mary,
I'm kidding.
Yeah, you be sure to put this on your resume.
Yeah.
That you did traffic for Jerry Springer. Can you get arrested for trafficking?
In more ways than one.
What
listen
kind?
To her.
What?
No, what are you doing in that?
You know, I have to say, though, you did very well on Dancing with the Stars. You know who...
People wanted to hurt me. That's why they voted for me to hurt me.
How many weeks did it take before you got the boot?
Seven
See,
weeks.
See, that's good. If you're booted in the first couple of weeks,
that's
bad. I
wanted to go after the second week. No, actually, the truth is, I wanted to learn the waltz for Katie, my daughter's wedding, and so... That was the fourth week. So I really was trying hard to make it to the fourth week because that was the week they would give us the waltz. And that was great, and we loved it, and Katie was there, and it was just a wonderful moment. After that, I was really hurting. And plus, you got to learn a new dance every week, and it was just – and I was begging, please stop it. Just stop it.
Did you think of quitting?
No, I wanted people to vote me off. You can't quit.
Well, at least you didn't
they
break
just kept.
Anything.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, exactly.
It became a vengeance. People really upset. For example, with my television show, they took it out on me and they kept voting me through. And it was really bad for the show because I was lasting longer than people who really knew how to dance on the show. In other words, they were being voted off, and that really was unfair. And they would have ruined the show. So eventually, thankfully, I was voted off. But it was a great.
The
show.
Lines around NBC Tower started to dwindle. Little by little, they wouldn't stretch all the way down Columbus.
Do you realize where, as soon as I'm finished doing the show, I go like one block over to do my show?
Not even. Probably a couple of hop, skips, and a jump over there.
Yeah. By the way, I want to apologize for my TV show. So just, do I have a moment for a bit of advice?
You have a lot of moments.
Look,
Three
hours of this? Holy
cow. Well, 2:40, thank God.
Okay. Now, I know there are going to be people listening who just are... outraged that I could be sitting here, and they're just very unhappy. They hate my television show, and you know I'm the devil incarnate, and all that. And I'm sorry you feel that way, but I want to help you. And I don't. This is just a radio program, so I don't want you doing anything crazy. I'm going to give you some hotline numbers. You know, if you need to be talked down from your anger.
Wait, let me get a pen.
Okay. For example, if you're living in a tall building with the windows open. Step away from the window. Either that or step away from the radio. You can call. Where do we have the list of the numbers?
Oh, here.
Oh, do you have it?
Oh, of course. Are you kidding? I have it in bold in front of me. I may use it in about 20 minutes.
Yeah, no, but see, this doesn't have what the numbers are. It just has the names of the places. Okay, we're going to get
We'll get the numbers.
But there's a Chicago Counseling Center you can call. There's an anger management hotline. There's the Pfizer Viagra hotline. Why are you calling that?
I don't on there.
I don't know, but...
Your producer did this to you, by the way.
Yeah, but I think I just asked him for the number. I didn't ask him. That had nothing to do with the show.
You just put it
great.
Out there.
The White House switchboard. If things are really going bad and you think I'm hurting America, then call the White House switchboard. And then the MAQ news tip line. because
why the MAQ?
Well, because the last time, you know, when I 12, 13, 14 years ago, when they had me do a commentary one night and all the people quit, that's what we were afraid you all were going to walk out.
Well, there's still time.
Yeah, but think of the economy.
There's
you
still
walk
time.
Out. I'm gone Friday. Then Monday, you
oh,
come
yeah,
back
right.
here for a job. What if the job isn't here anymore? This is no time to be quitting your job.
How many days is short-term disability, Mary? Oh, four? 4 days?
Oh, well, 4 days.
3 days,
work.
4 hours, yeah, and work. 30
oh,
minutes.
Don't go.
No, I'm kidding.
Andrea,
go ahead. I'm not. I'm with you. I said I would help you.
You are a very nice
I will
lady.
Be the...
You are a very nice young woman.
Just
okay.
make sure she doesn't take a nap.
And then for me, they have a rejection hotline. I have to deal with rejection every day.
You do not.
Oh, I do. Oh, it's horrible. And the first time I was rejected, Phoebe Nellaboff.
Does this go back to like a prom date?
Yes.
I knew it.
Phoebe Nellaboff, and if she's listening, you know, she could be this wonderful young lady. She's not young anymore. She's my age. She's 65. But this was my high school prom, and she canceled my prom date, which was my first date. My first date.
On prom night?
The night before the prom. True story. Canceled the date. Said she wasn't feeling well. How did she know what she was going to feel like tomorrow? And as a consolation, I went with my mom and dad to the Turnpike restaurant in Queens, New York.
I thought you were going to say you went with them to the prom.
No.
I was going to say, that's even
and
worse.
They took me out to dinner. And I'm sitting there on prom night with mom and dad, who, God bless them, I love them immensely. But, you know, on your prom night, you don't want
right,
to be with your
right.
mom and dad.
No,
and
definitely
I have dealt
not.
With that forever, and that's why I do the show I do today.
Hey, Jerry,
because I don't handle rejection. Well, I'm steamed.
Can I tell you?
What?
She just wasn't that into you. If you cancel the prom the night before. Sorry.
Yeah, that
I
is.
I mean.
She no, it's fine. It's fine. I, you know. But don't know. She's probably thinking now, oh, boy, I could have been rolling in the dough.
Oh, I thought you were going to say rolling something else.
No, thank
about
God.
It.
Yeah, think about it. No, I'm not that kind of a guy. Think about it, Phoebe. Big bucks.
Phoebe, if you're out there, give us a call.
You could
312.
It could have been a big home.
591.
Jet plane. Life could have been good, Phoebe, huh?
Actually,
huh? No, I'm not feeling well. I don't want to go with Gerald to the prom.
Actually, Phoebe called. She wanted some of these hotline numbers.
Okay.
We're going to get those numbers out, too.
Yes. And we're going to take a break now. And when we come back, we're going to talk about, get this, how the liberals won.
This is where I step away. We'll be back after this on GN.